of you here this morning. Please be seated. A special welcome to all who are visiting with us today, and we hope you'll be able to stay for a time of fellowship with us after the service. And to all those joining us online, we're glad to have you with us today as well as we worship God together here. And for our gathering chorus, let's sing together, "Here I Am to Worship." And mercy are infinite, and in you all things work together for good. In this time of worship, we offer you our thanks with our prayers. We offer you praise with our hearts, and we honor you with our lives this day and every day. As we worship you this day, Lord God, we come before you with the knowledge that everything we have has been given to us as a gift from you. And as we give thanks for all of the ways you love us and bless us, we pray together now using the words that Jesus gave to us as we pray together saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." And our opening hymn this morning is We Praise You, Creator. Trust in you and follow you. Rather than pray and ask for your guidance, we flounder and wonder where you are and why you are not intervening. Please forgive us, Lord, for the times when we need your guidance but fail to ask for it, for the times we fail to follow you, and the times we fail to trust in you, and as a result, we struggle needlessly. Loving God, help us to follow you, not just when things are going well, but especially when things get tough. Knowing that you are always with us and you are always working out what is best for us. Help us to trust in you more, Lord. For we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Hear the good news. God has promised mercy and forgiveness to all who repent and turn to him. If you have confessed your sins through your faith in Christ, you are forgiven. Praise be to God. Amen. And I invite you now to turn in your pew Bibles to page 507 as we have our responsive reading.
Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous. Praise befits the upright.
Praise the Lord, the
Lord. Make melody to him with harp and strings.
Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully on the strings with loud shouts.
The word of the Lord is upright, and all his work is done in faithfulness.
He loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of the steadfast love of the Lord.
By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, and all their hosts by the breath of his mouth.
He gathered the waters of the sea as in a bottle. He put the depth in the storehouses.
Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him.
For he spoke, and it came to be. He commanded, and it stood firm.
The Lord brings the counsel of the nations to nothing. He frustrates the plans of the peoples.
The counsel of the Lord stands forever. The thoughts of his hearts to all generations.
Happy is the nation whose God is the Lord, the people whom he has chosen as his heritage.
The Lord looks down from heaven. He sees all humankind.
From where he sits enthroned, he watches all the inhabitants of the earth.
He who fashions the hearts of them all and observes all their deeds.
A king is not saved by his great army. A warrior is not delivered by his great strength.
The war horse is a vain hope for victory, and by its great might it cannot save.
Truly the eye of the Lord is on those who fear him, on those who hope in his steadfast love.
To deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine.
Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and shield.
Our heart is glad in him because we trust in his holy name.
Let your steadfast love, O Lord, be upon us, even as we hope in you.
Amen.
The needs of others. Heavenly Father, amid the distractions and worries we each carry within us this day, may your Holy Spirit quiet our hearts and minds so that we will give you our undivided attention and listen and learn from the truth of your word. And all this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Our first reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, and we will be reading verses 1 through 9, and if you would like to follow in your pew Bible, you'll find us on page 165. Page 165 in the New Testament section of your pew Bible, reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. And here we read, Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and our brother Sosthenes, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, together with all those who in every place call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, both their Lord and ours. Grace to you, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And now turning back to page 34, we're going to be reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, and verses 16 through 20. Page 34, reading from Matthew, chapter 28, beginning at verse 16. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." These are the words of our Lord. Thanks be to God. I suspect that many, if not most of us here, have cell phones. They have become virtually indispensable to daily life. Whereas a cell phone was once seen as a luxury, it's now considered a necessity. Like most cell phones, mine keeps track of missed calls. Sometimes I miss a call if I'm driving or if I'm on another call. Other times I miss a call because I'm on the church phone or I'm in a meeting or counseling someone. We have all experienced the frustration of trying to contact someone and not being able to reach them. Maybe their phone rings unanswered because they don't have an answering machine or a voicemail. Other times you hear the words, "Sorry I missed your call, but if you leave a message for me, I'll try to get back to you." I was thinking of this all in relation to our scripture passages for today because the word "call" and "called" appear multiple times, especially in our reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 1. In the Presbyterian Church, we often refer to a call, or calling, or being called. And in many ways, it's a particularly Presbyterian word, or term. And we even use it to describe the relationship between ministers and congregations. For Presbyterians, being a minister isn't just a job or a career, it's a calling. But the term is not meant to be limited to ministers. God calls each and every one of us. What does it mean to be called? Well, one of the best ways to understand it is to think of the word vocation. According to the dictionary, a vocation is an occupation to which a person is especially drawn, or for which he or she is particularly suited, trained, or qualified. The word vocation is from the Latin vocatio, which means a call or a summons. The idea of a vocation or call is central to Christian belief that God has created each person with gifts and abilities that are to be used for the sake of the greater good. According to the website vocations.ca, a vocation is God's unique invitation for you. A particular way for you to live your life to the fullest. Your response is expected not just as a single act, but as a lifelong process, or what we would call a journey of faith. In other words, God's call on your life is not limited to a one-time event. The call may change and develop through the years. So you see, call is not exclusive to ministers or even to particularly gifted individuals. Each person, every individual, is called by God to do something. God calls each one of us for a purpose. And while I can't claim to know what each person's specific purpose or call is, I know for certain that it is always for a good purpose. God calls us to Him, and then He transforms our lives and then uses us to transform the world. Have you ever stopped to think about God's call on your life? Or even the fact that God has called you? If you haven't, you're not alone. It's something most people struggle with. I think it's because most of us associate God's calling as being directed to those who go into some form of professional ministry. But God does call each one of us. How do you discern that call? Well, your natural God-given abilities may indicate where God has called you. And sometimes others around us identify those better than we do ourselves. Have you ever heard someone say to you, "Oh, you missed your calling"? People often say that when they see a talent or ability we possess that we haven't recognized within ourselves. Your training for your job or your career may also indicate where God is calling you, as may your interests or your hobbies. Discovering the call God has for you as an individual can seem intimidating and overwhelming, and we can find ourselves second-guessing our decisions and our choices as we try to figure out what God wants us to do. You may have heard of or even read the book series The Lord of the Rings by J.R.R. Tolkien. To summarize the series in two sentences, Frodo, the hero, is given a ring by his uncle. It turns out that the ring possesses great power, and Frodo is called to go on a journey to destroy the ring in order to defeat the evil Dark Lord. At one point, Frodo begins to question and even doubt his calling. Gandalf, a kind and wise wizard, says to him, "We cannot decide the time we live in. All we have to decide is what we do with the time we are given." The same is true of God's call to each one of us. God calls each one of us, and He gives each one of us gifts and abilities to live out that calling. We can't choose the talents and gifts we receive, but we can decide what we do with them. So the question each one of us has to ask ourselves is, what am I doing with what I have been given? God calls each one of us to serve Him by using our talents and abilities to make a difference in this world. For a few, it will mean doing great and noble things, but for most of us, it will be doing smaller things. Things that often go unnoticed and unheralded by the rest of the world, but things that are no less noble in God's eyes. And while we may sometimes struggle to fully discover and identify our individual call, there is one universal call, the call God makes to each and every one of us. In Isaiah, chapter 49, verses 6 and 7, God is speaking to the people of Israel about the mission He has for them. And He says, "It is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribe of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth." This was shocking news to the people of Israel. They had been God's chosen people, but now God was telling them that their outlook was too limited. That, as He says, it is too light a thing. He is calling them to look beyond themselves, to reach out even to their enemies, so that the news of God's salvation might reach all people, to the ends of the earth, He says. It may not have been what they wanted to hear, but it was what God was calling them to do. And it's much the same for us. We are God's people here at St. Mark's. We are each called to engage in the ministry and outreach of this church by giving our money and our time, not just to keep this church going, but so that we as a congregation will have the resources to reach out into the community and beyond and offer programs that will help people, that will change people's lives for good and draw them into a relationship with Jesus Christ. That is our calling. That is what God wants us to do with our lives. And Jesus renewed God's call on our lives when he commanded that we go forth and make disciples of all nations. But so often we are tempted to scale that back to something we see as more attainable, something less costly, something easier. Instead of going out into the world or even into our own neighborhoods, we wait for them to come to us. But God doesn't want us to think small or to hold back. He wants us to think big. Make disciples of all nations, Jesus says. God's plan is for the salvation of all people. It's the message that we are called to share with the world. We can't choose who will listen and receive the message, or who will ignore the message, or totally reject it. That's not for us to decide. All we can decide is whether or not we answer God's call to share the message of salvation. The call is for each and every one of us. Jesus calls everyone, but not everyone answers. Sometimes it's because people miss the call. They don't hear it, or they're preoccupied with other things. And sometimes it's because they've simply ignored it. When Christ calls you, and he will call, will you answer and say, "What can I do for you?" Or will he hear, "I'm sorry, I can't take your call right now, but if you leave a message for me, I'll try to get back to you." When Christ calls, how will you answer? Amen.
Amen.
And as we think about the call that God has on each one of us in our lives, let's sing together, "Will You Come and Follow Me?" announcements to share with you. One is a reminder that the baby bottle campaign for the Island Pregnancy Center is coming to a close. It finishes next Sunday. And they provide a much needed service to pregnant women and families in our community and across the province. And there are information cards in the foyer and also details in the bulletin for those who would like to donate. As I said at the beginning of the service, we hope you'll stay for fellowship time after the service this morning. And just to note that today is our final fellowship time until the Sunday after Labor Day. We're taking a little break for the summer to give all our fellowship time hosts a break. And the sign-up sheets for the fall are on the guest book table. And if you're able to host on a Sunday, the crackers, cheese, and tea and coffee are all provided. You just need to set things up and actually host the time and clean up after. But if you're able to sign up for a fall Sunday, that would be greatly appreciated. But again, today is our last fellowship time until the Sunday after Labor Day. You'll also have noted on the slides and in the bulletin that Vacation Bible School is coming up the week of July 10th to 14th. Registration forms are in the foyer, or you can also sign up online. Susie has set up an online registration form, and it's available through the church website. She's also selling paper magnifying glasses to support VBS, and I see a growing number of them out in the foyer, so you can speak to her about that as well. And Susie just got back. I picked her up in Crapo at 11:15 on Wednesday night, and that was after they left General Assembly early to get back. But she's going to give us a report next Sunday about her experience at General Assembly last week. So we will look forward to that, Susie. Coming up this week, men's breakfast will be Wednesday at 8 a.m. at Smitty's Restaurant. And Tom is due back tomorrow night, and he's bringing Rachel and Alexander with him. So we're all looking forward to having them all here. And so just a reminder to the men that Wednesday morning at 8 o'clock, men's breakfast at Smitty's Restaurant. And be sure and take your bulletin with you. And if you haven't picked up a June calendar, please do so. And that way you can note any of the other events coming up. And as we continue to think about God's call on our lives and how we can answer that call, the choir is going to sing Forever Yours to Be. Thank you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you this day with grateful hearts, trusting that you walk with us throughout our lives. Lord God, you create a future for us, calling each one of us to use our individual abilities and opportunities to make a difference. We thank you that we all have a place and purpose in your world. Help each one of us to hear your call and to answer and respond in faith, so that indeed, forever yours we will be. Loving God, we pray for our church family near and far. We pray each one of us will know that you indeed have a plan and purpose for us, and that we will seek to serve you wherever you call us, in our jobs, in our families, in our neighborhoods, with our friends, in our hobbies, as we participate in sports and activities. Wherever we are and whatever we do, may we be witnesses for you and the gospel of Christ. Lord, we pray this day for all those who need healing, whether in body, in mind, or in spirit. We pray especially today for Ralph Sanderson as he is in hospital, that you will strengthen and heal him. And we pray also for healing for Travis and for Jennifer. Please bless them. Loving God, we pray for our community, for our province, and for our nation. We pray for all of the areas still being impacted by wildfires and for those enduring the effects of the lingering smoke from the fires. Please be with the firefighters who are working so diligently. Send rain, Lord, and may the fires quickly be contained and extinguished. And we pray especially this day for all those who have suffered the loss of property or their businesses, and pray that they will indeed get the help they need as they seek to rebuild. Lord God, we continue to pray for peace in Ukraine and in Sudan. May peacemakers rise up and bring lasting peace. And please bless all those who are working for peace. Heavenly Father, as we begin this new week, we pray that you will help us to live out our faith and give us the courage to answer your call to share the good news of salvation through our faith in Christ. For it is in his name we pray. Amen. And our closing praise this morning is, "We've a Story to Tell to the Nations."
Thank you.
thank you so much for being willing. Josh is thrown into the deep end this morning, training to do AV, and we're so appreciative of anyone who's willing to help us out on the AV team. So thank you, Josh. And let's sing our benediction together.